Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Yesterday I went on a bike ride and it was so sunny and hot. I wished I'd worn a hat. So when I woke up this morning, I thought it would be perfect to share some hat hairstyles. I am wearing an assortment of hats for all of these different styles, so let me know in the comment section which ones are your favorite. Be sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss any future videos, and let's get started. For the first hairstyle, I'm going to begin by dividing off two sections, each one from above my ears, and I'm going to bring these two sections together at the back of my head and then tie them off with an elastic band. I'm going to flip the ends around the elastic band, creating two twisted sections. I'm going to go back over the two twists and gently pull on small sections of hair to loosen them out of the elastic so the twists are more full. And now I'm going to divide off two new sections of hair, each one just below the twists, and I'm going to bring these over the rest of the hair and tie them together using another elastic band. And once they're tied off, I'm just going to pull on small sections of hair right above the elastic band so they slide out of the elastic just slightly, and this will create two puffier sections. And now I'm going to divide off two new sections of hair, both from underneath the previously tied section, and I'm going to bring these over the rest of the hair like before and tie them together with another elastic band. Again, I'm going to gently pull on small sections of hair above the elastic so the two sections are bigger and more full. And I'm just going to repeat those steps and continue the braid down the length of my hair, dividing off two sections of hair on each side, tying them together over the top of the other hair, and then making each section puffier and more full by gently pulling the hair out of the elastic. I created about five sections total. I just went down until I really couldn't reach my hair anymore. And the further down you go, sometimes the sections can start to sit lopsided because the elastic gets tied tighter on one side, or you can't quite pull out the hair as evenly on both sides. But then I'm just going to add my hat, and I think this is a really cool spin on a traditional braid. You're going to love the next hairstyle. It's so much easier than it looks. So for this style, I'm going to begin by combining all of my hair together at the nape of my neck. Using a hairband, I'm going to tie all of the hair together and create a little loop in the hair on the last wrap of the elastic. So now I'm going to take all of the ends that are hanging out the bottom of the bun, and I'm going to braid this hair into a regular three-strand braid. So I'm dividing the hair into three sections, and I'm going to cross the side strands over the middle strand. And I'm just going to work my way down the section of hair until the braid reaches the bottom. And now I'm going to go back over the braid, and I want to make it really wide. So I'm going to pull on the edges enough that it's a lot bigger, but not so much that the hair starts to fall out of the braid. And then I'm going to grab an elastic band and tie off the end of the braid. Now I'm going to take the braid and lay it over the top of the bun, and then just pin it down wherever it feels loose. I slid a couple bobby pins underneath the bun to hold down the ends, and then I slid one into the top of the braid so it'd stay in place there, and then I put one more on the right side where I had a couple sections of hair sticking out from the braid. And then I just added my hat, and I love how this style turned out. It looks so much more complicated than it actually is, but really only takes a few minutes to do. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to begin by dividing my hair into two sections, so I have a left side and a right side. I'm going to combine all of the hair on the left side first and tie it off using an elastic band. Then I'm going to tie a second elastic a couple inches down from the first one. I'm going to create a gap in the hair, and then I'm going to flip the rest of the hair through this gap so the two side sections are twisted. Now I'm going to go back over the two sections and gently pull on the edges. Then I'm going to tie a third elastic band a couple inches down from the previous one and repeat the same steps again, creating a gap in the hair and flipping the ends through the gap so the two side sections are twisted. Then I'm going to go back over the two twists and pull out small pieces of hair so the two twists are larger and more full. And I'm just going to repeat the same steps with the hair on the right side. So I'm going to first tie all of the hair together with an elastic band, and then I'm going to create three more twisted sections with this right section of hair, tying three more elastic bands down the section of hair and flipping each one through the gap while pulling on the twisted sections so they're puffier and show up better. If you recreate this version, you can do it exactly the way that I do it. You can also create a bunch of small, tiny sections, or just a couple of sections, and have longer ponytails on the ends. Play around with it and just see what you like best. I have to share a high bun in this compilation of hat hairstyles. So the next look is a messy bun, but this is a new technique for me and it's super easy to do. I'm going to start by placing my hat over my head so it's sitting around my neck. Then I'm going to combine all of my hair together at the top of my head, placing it where I want my bun to sit. I'm going to first tie it all together using a hairband. So now I'm going to take the ponytail and I'm going to twist it around the hairband in a clockwise pattern. And as I wrap it around the hairband, I'm also going to gently twist the hair together into a twist to help keep it combined together. So once it's all wrapped, I'm going to take a clear elastic band and wrap it over the top of the bun. I personally love my messy buns really big and puffy, so I'm going to gently pull on the edges of the bun to make the twisted sections a lot fuller. I'm going to take some bobby pins and go around the edges of the bun and pin down different sections. This will ensure the bun stays flush against my head, even though it's been slightly loosened from the hair elastic. And now I'm just going to take my hat and carefully slide it up to my head so it fits exactly where I want it around my face. This is one of my favorite hairstyles for swimming because it keeps my hair from getting wet while still protecting my face from the sun. I think it's such a classy style as well and a great look to keep in your list of favorites. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to start by combining all of my hair together at the back of my head and tie it off using a hairband. And now I'm going to take the ponytail and divide it into three equal sections. I'm going to braid the hair into a regular three-strand braid. So I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between the left and right strands, and I'm just going to work my way down the section of hair until it reaches near the bottom. So I'm just crossing the left strand over the middle, then crossing the right strand over the middle. And I like to stop braiding before it gets too little that I can't really pull it apart. So once I go down far enough, I'm going to tie off the end of the braid with a clear elastic band. Now that the braid is done, I'm going to go back over the braid and pull it apart as much as I possibly can without making it completely fall apart. So I'm starting at the very top and I'm going to pull the hair upwards to make the top section really puffy. Then I'm going to work my way down the braid, pulling small sections of hair slightly out of the hairband from along the sides of the braid and down the middle so it becomes twice as big and full. This is one of my favorite hairstyles to wear with a hat because it's heatless, but it also keeps your hair off of your neck. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to begin by dividing off a section of hair on both sides of my head, right above both ears, and I'm going to bring these two sections together at the back of my head. Using a clear elastic band, I'm going to tie the two sections together and then flip the ends around the elastic so the two sides are twisted. I'm going to go back over the two twists and gently pull on small sections of hair to loosen them out of the elastic so the twists are more full. Now I'm going to divide off two new sections of hair from the sides of my neck right underneath the previous section, and I'm going to bring these over the rest of the hair and tie them together with another elastic band. I'm going to flip the ends around the elastic so the sides are twisted, and then I'm going to gently pull on the edges of the twists so they're fuller. And I'm just going to repeat those steps, dividing off sections of hair from the sides, bringing them over the top of the other hair, and then using a clear elastic band, I'm going to tie the two sections together. And I'm also going to flip each section around the elastic to create twisted sections, and then gently pull on the edges of the twists so they're bigger and more full. I created about 5 sections of the braid and just went down until it got too hard to reach the hair. I like the braid to reach close to the ends, but far enough away that I still have kind of a fluffy tail at the bottom. But then once that's done, I'm just going to add my hat to finish the style. For the last hairstyle, I'm going to start by combining all of my hair over my left shoulder, and I'm going to divide it into 2 equal sections. Since I'm doing a fishtail braid, I'm going to divide off a small section of hair from one side and cross it under to the opposite side. And I'm just going to continue the braid working down the section. So I'm just dividing off small sections of hair from one side, crossing it under to the opposite side, and working all the way down to the bottom. Once I've braided the hair all the way down to the bottom, I'm just going to hold the end of the braid in one hand and then go back over the sides and gently pull on the edges. Then once the braid is really big and full, I'm just going to tie off the end of the braid using a clear elastic band and then just add my hat as the finishing touch. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Be sure to let me know in the comment section which of the hairstyles was your favorite, and make sure to subscribe so you never miss any future videos, and I will see you next time.